How are we doing, Robust Family? Look, before this show starts, which I know you're gonna enjoy, can I ask you just to do me a small favor? I need all of you to give a robust smash to that like and subscribe button. Why? Because it helps us a lot. We wanna get this material out there, and it makes sure that you do not miss a breakfast show beat on this Liberty Radio YouTube channel. All right, guys, do it right now, and I'll see you in the show. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a great day, a powerful day with gusto and determination inside of our souls, guys. This is your breakfast show, and I'm your host, Robert Ashitey, your robust presenter. And I'm gonna be with you from now until the hours of 10 o'clock this wonderful, fine day. And joining me in the studios, I am never alone. I am never alone. Joining me in the studios today, we have the lady of sound herself. It is the one, it is the only, we call her Kathleen. Hi! Morning. Good morning to you. Good morning to you, Kathleen.
How are you?
How am I? I'm good. How are you today, Kat?
I'm good.
Yeah, you're fully ready for the Thursday, Kat?
Yeah.
With your computer systems that you got there, you got everything locked and loaded.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. I'm going to put you on the spot just a little bit now. I can see you're already ready for the day. What's one word you'd like to say to our listeners this morning, Kat?
Ajaluj,
here we go. And speaking of Ajaluj, we have another ray of light joining us first thing in the studio this morning. It's the one, it's the only, it's the lady that I think a patwa every time I mention her name. But don't worry, man, she's awesome. Straight from Wood Green, it's Lady Shirley. Good morning, Shirley. Morning there, your camera there. It's all the man, my camera there. Good morning. How you doing today, Shirley?
I'm very, very good, thank you.
Yeah, I can see you're like you're rising up.
Yes, I am.
I can see you falling. You're like, now we're doing this today.
Yeah, Kathleen said Ajaluj, so
Ajaluj.
Let there be light inside of me too.
Yes.
We're gonna go light inside us today. Look, man, it's great to have you with us.
Thank you.
Punching the light into you.
Oh yeah, over her. Don't to me. All right, there we go. As you go receive, you go be like,
I'm receiving.
Here we go. All right, guys. And if you are receiving the light this morning, come type in the live chat, say, good morning, breakfast show. As you know, we do, because this is your program, this is your show. And we start the day with vim, gusto, determination inside of our hearts. So today is a wonderful day. It's one of my favorite days of the week, even though I love every day of the week. It is Jamo. J'amo. I see you, Jack. I see you. Today is love therapy. Ooh. We're starting Thursday on a high. If you went to La Park last week, then you're okay, cause you will remember today. J'amo. That's right, guys. It's Relationship Power Thursday here on your breakfast show. And we're going to be learning today. We're going to be learning here with Bishop James, as we look at elements from last Thursday's love therapy. I know you was unwell last week.
Yes,
you was recovering from flu. And you know, for those of us like who get to do the show, it's really beautiful, the things that we learn, especially things that has been spoken about in the love talk. I think we're gonna have some really good marriages coming out from this love talk. Yes, you're creating hearts that make me feel jealous. Yeah. Good, yeah. Doesn't work.
You know something that feels very unnatural to me? Have you seen people that do hearts like this?
Okay.
It's weird, like with these fingers down.
Oh, okay, with these fingers down. But isn't that normal?
No, just these two fingers. It's weird.
Oh, right, because you're blocking it, right?
Yeah.
But then that's like horns, and you're going to be told you're Illuminati or something.
You're like... That's why it's like this.
Yeah, like that. But then you've got that whole archery business where you've got the archeries. Have you heard about that, Shirley?
Your archeries.
Like, so basically, when you see them doing all that business, like with that, like that, it's actually like your heart. And that's your arteries leading from your heart.
That's not a heart.
No, but it's like a literal heart. Like they're It's like they're doing. I know we think like this, right?
Yeah.
Like, but they're like going into it. Kat loves that sign all the time.
Really?
Yeah, she's throwing up gang signs like that, man. So it's like, because it's like that in your bed, in your body. You got the two artery valves coming out.
You know how they say that your fist is the size of your heart?
Yeah.
So then these two are the arteries pumping the blood.
My fingers can't move like this.
Yeah, oh really?
I'm struggling.
Oh wow. I don't know. Like, Kat's the one who teach me these things, you know. I'm learning with her every day. You see the situation?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, oh, there's somebody at the door.
Oh, there's somebody at the door. There's somebody at the door. Hey, look who it is. The one and only. I am Will. How you doing, my man? Take a seat, brother. Take a seat. The table of justice is becoming propagated slowly but surely. But guys, as we were saying, we're talking about hearts, heart signs, gang signs, and all kinds of signs. But it's all about love, relationship power Thursday here on The Breakfast Show. And we're really going to get into this today because I don't know if you saw the advert. Kat, have you got the advert that was made that we put on Instagram? Yeah. That Instagram advert. I thought that Instagram advert was so nice. I'd love to show it. The one that you created, Kat? The clip that you created.
Oh. The one that was out really late?
Yeah. Thanks for that, Will. If I was to say it, it'd just come out differently, you know what I'm saying?
I made sure to watch it before I slept. It was literally the last thing I saw.
It hit though, innit?
It did.
I love it. I love the creativity. This lady here is awesome. By the way, Kat's our editor, our chief editor. When it comes to our social media stuff, absolutely awesome. Just makes everything fun.
I was gonna say the videos, and I don't know if you've been working on the MCQ templates as well.
Yes,
but I really like the templates recently. They're really. I can't think of the right adjective for it, but everything's so like smooth and well put together in terms of that color scheme.
All right. Thank you.
That's positive.
Yeah, I'm a fan.
That's it.
Thank you.
Yeah, give her a cupboard, give her a corner, and her mobile phone. She got it done. She got it covered. It's Kat, man. It's a Kat thing. All right, guys, let's have a look in the live chat this morning. And inside the live chat, oh, look, it's kicking off. Wow. Okay. Oh, I should have started earlier.
Do you want to show the video or do you want to do the comments?
Okay, let's share the video because I like the video. Check this video out, guys. It's kicking off. Hey, how we doing? Breakfast Show Faithful. This is Robert here, Robust Presenter. And tomorrow's show is going to be awesome. Just imagine this lady here. She had some relationship baggage. Check this out. All right. And guess what? It isn't just relationship baggage, which is just heavy. Inside of it, she has a perfume. All right. And as well as perfume, she has a lip balm. All right, which no one both can smell or see. But guess what? These items are laced with poison.
Dun, dun, dun.
That's right. What would happen to anyone she interacts with or anyone she gets close to or forms a relationship with? They will get unwell, get sick, and become poisoned. We're going to be looking at that tomorrow on your breakfast show from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. tomorrow on libertyradio.co.uk. Relationship baggage that we can hide, but is like poison to those around us. We're going to have our table of justice full with Selena Green. We're going to have the one and only Ignatius Hango. We're going to have I Am Will. Amelia will be joining us as well tomorrow. As well as that, we're also going to be having...
I was going to say Sabrina.
That was crazy. That was awesome.
That was so
and that
cool.
Cough was not planned.
It wasn't planned. The perfume went into my back of my throat. And I started coughing at the end. I tried to firm it.
You actually can't. You really can't.
I don't like doing
takes. Sprayed it in my face.
Yeah, she sprayed it in your face.
Yeah.
She just got gung-ho. She was like... And after doing the first one, you know, you get hyped and confident. Cats are like... Seriously, but it's good. Guys, if you're not part of the official Liberty Radio Instagram, make sure you are. If you're not, here's the Instagram site. Make sure you click it. Make sure you follow so you do not miss a breakfast show beat every single day. You get those nice little animation clips that are being made, and I'm sure it'll keep you up to speed, and you can share it with other people. We want more people connected to the Instagram channel, more people to know about it. Like you said, you got it straight away in the evening, isn't it, when it went up, and it's like it came up late, you know, but I caught it. Also, as well as the Instagram channel, you know that we communicate heavily since the Breakfast Show started on the Breakfast Show What's Up line. Saved us a lot during what's that situation called again? You know when everyone was locked away?
COVID.
Yeah. Oh gosh, you can't say that. Oh. Yeah. I don't know, right? Everyone's like on the internet, like, you can't say that word.
Really?
Yeah, because the algorithm starts to hunt you down and shut down your material.
Oh yeah.
There you go.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Can you speak about COVID?
Why have to go keep saying that? We have to go keep saying that, man.
We're on the radar.
This is 2024.
When you speak about COVID-19.
Yeah, that situation.
Yeah.
Yeah. That situation that affected the world. So this is the Breakfast Show What's Up line. It's helped us since those days, and just send us a message, add me to the Breakfast Show broadcast so I never miss a Breakfast Show beat. You'll know everything, things that happen behind the scenes, when the program's about to start. If supposing I get caught up, there's cancellations of transport, I will let you guys know. Everything, we let everyone know what's happening behind the scenes. You know, we're gonna do it, we just do it, innit, guys?
Just do it.
Nike. All right, speaking of just doing it, we have our talkers here on the Breakfast Show. What are you, Tyler's here with us saying, good morning, Breakfast Show family. Have a great and amazing weekend. Thank you, Retro Guy. You are absolutely...
Thank you. Oh.
It's been a long time. Catch it, mate. Catch it.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. We have to get those.
Should I just return it?
Return it to me, yeah. Over to you. Shirley. That's it. Oh, put it up in the... Oh! Over to Kat. Retro Guy's in the house. Okay. That's it, man. Retro Guy's been good to have you with us. I want all the shows at Tyler in Ilford. And good morning, Breakfast Show family. Have a great day, amazing weekend. Thank you. Dave is in the house saying, good morning, BSF. Hope everyone's have a Thursday. Thursdays are blessed. Thank you, David. Mr. Gillette Smart says, good morning, a Breakfast Show staff. Mr. Robert, may God fuel all of your Breakfast Show staffs with all of his blessings so that you never run out of reasons to be happy.
Amen. Literally.
Amen. That's nice. You like that one, Shirley?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. It hits. He knows how to bless. It's nice. Thanks, Mr. Gillette Smart. You're awesome. Also, Mercy in Cardiff says, morning, BSF family and the Table of Justice today and cats. Yeah, that's from Mercy in Cardiff. Evelyn is with us from France saying, good morning, family, and a blessed day to everyone. Good morning, Miss Evelyn. You are absolutely awesome. I just do things on the fly, don't I?
Yeah.
It's only in certain moments I actually like jump out and I'm like, did I just do that? Lorraine from Boring says, good morning, Assistant Robert and Breakfast Show crew. Mighty Boring connected, one dream, one team. Why have to go spoil it for Kat? Why you have to do the whole thing of the person barfing like that? It's like one dream, one team.
Do you notice how the sun is shining on you right now?
Oh wow, this is awesome. Oh wow, look at this, is great.
Oh yeah.
It is. spring is arriving, guys, little by little.
Little by little,
Shirley.
Emphasis.
Spring. Huh?
I was going to say emphasis on the little. Yeah. By little.
It's gonna rain today.
Why?
Isn't it?
Why? We have to go jinx it, Shirley.
Apart from
it's wood green peeps. They just keep it real, you know. It's wood green, just like it's what it is. Bro.
Well, there's no though. We do kind of just get more. We get like almost 80% of the same weather all year round, and then only just some that show up in a certain part.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was just me, but when I ask people, like, do you remember that it rained a lot last summer?
Yeah.
And some people don't remember that, but I feel like it was raining every week last summer.
Last summer was hot.
Was what?
And it was very hot.
And that's the response I usually get. Yeah. Like, oh, it's just hot. And it was hot, but it was raining.
Yeah.
Often.
Yes, Brad. Because like now we're April. Prepare. Often it could be snowfall.
Yeah, all hail.
All hail, like we had last week. Hailstones randomly. Look, man, those of you in, you know, those of you out of Europe.
The sun is powerful.
Wow.
Wow,
that's also awesome. This is great. This is. I think we're gonna have to use something to blind it because my eyes. All right. Anyway, we prayed for it and it's here. And Amelia from Stratford saying, "Good morning, all. Good morning, Amelia. Great to have you with us on the show." Chanel from Cuba's in the house. Lady Jazz saying, "Good morning." Mark from Croydon. You know we gotta do something. All right, guys. I've got I've got Ignatius Hango on the line. Hang on a second, Ignatius. So the living God, I've got you here on air. How you doing, brother? You're almost, y'all joining us. Yep.
I'm here late, but...
No, you're good. The table of justice is, we're just getting warmed up. Y'all doing fine. All right, superpower. I'll come, we'll have a break and I'll come down and get you, okay?
Thank you.
Fantastic. Look, guys, this is a live show, man. This is a breakfast show. You know what I'm saying? It's a breakfast show, kitchen, family just passing through. This is what we do every morning. From 8 to 10. I was in the weird snare, didn't I? Like I was going to jump into your body. like Casper the Ghost. Okay, we have Abba N saying good morning. Good morning, Abba N and Lady Jazz and Lucky. That's it. Everyone's greeting each other from Park Station, South Africa. Chanel from South Africa says good morning, breakfast show fam. Clive is in the house. Alicia from Wood Green. I'm seeing the blue, the yellow, the green dots. Wood Green always support.
Paint in the city green.
You have to put her on the screen when she has to say that again. So what were you guys doing?
Painting the city green.
You're Wood Green. He lives near Wood Green as well.
We're taking over.
Oh gosh, wow. She's serious when she says it, you know. she got that look like, don't question it. Just accept.
You know something I want to raise a question? Is our cat used to rep... You're part of London, like, very consistently, or at least, you know, on shows I'm here. But I feel like you've not really
Yeah, she's an altar child. That means, like, she's... So, basically, her parents did work with God, so they move everywhere.
No.
But she was in Brixton, and she did used to rep Brixton a lot.
No, but I thought Brixton was, like, the one that was closest to your heart, because that used to be the one that you'd mention. What?
Wow. I don't keep anything in my heart. No branch in my heart.
What my no.
She says that now. But I get what you mean. We'll notice it, Cap.
Ah, there was definitely an affinity with Brixton. That explains then why you don't really give Brixton the airtime.
Yeah.
There you go. Because she's moved. That's why it stopped. But now she's Finsbury Park.
I get that part about the moving around stuff, but I just thought like, oh, you know, it'd be like random shouts. Oh, shout out Brixton. Hope you know everyone's. Oh, not no, even.
She's moving forward.
Yeah, I forgot about them already.
Oh,
it's in the past. Yeah.
There's a backstory there.
moving on. I just want to say, it's breakfast show, guys. A breakfast show kitchen. Woo. Family meet up here. It all happens here. Alicia from Wood Green says, good morning, breakfast show. Hajalush, indeed. Tyler from Boring's in the house saying, good morning. Good morning, Tyler from Boring. Boring, I definitely say support the breakfast show big time. Amelia from Stratford says, Korean hearts. Yep, that's it. Oh my gosh, I've got catching up to do. We've got Elliot saying, good morning, BSF. Have a blessed day to you all. Anonymous ending 513 says, good morning, breakfast show family. Have a blessed day. Dominic and Kyla's in the house. Oh yes, from Hackers. What does Wood Green think about Hackney? VYG.
There's not really much to think.
There's somebody at the door.
Oh, just before you fell into that trap. There's somebody at the door. There's somebody at the door. We got two of them. Here we go. Here we go. We got the one on Silly Green and we got the one on English Hands. Please take a seat. Take a seat. All right, we're going to organize a table of justice very shortly. This is great, you guys. All right, so as they settle in, let me see. So we got Clive. By the way, Clive is saying this is a great advert. People only focus on the outside but not on understanding the person's intentions. Amelia saying, my bad. Karina's in the house from Namibia. So definitely going to have a good day. Therese from Croydon is in the house.
Huh? Oh.
I said Croydon. Good morning to you, Therese. You'll be in Croydon. Gabriella is in the house from Hackney. We got Prince from Manchester in the house saying, keep my faith. Rave. Yahade. I think that's a song request. Anyway. We're going to work on ourselves. We're going to work on things today. It's relationship power. The table of justice is now complete. All right. The table of justice is now fully complete. Everyone's here. We're going to go for a time. I just organize ourselves. And when we come back, we're going to come back to you and get ready for the elements of last week's love talk. It's going to be powerful. We're looking at relationship baggage and the relationship baggage that is like poison that harms the person you're with and those around you. It's going to be really nice today. I'm really excited. We're right back in just a moment, right after this. Oh, sorry, Kat, what song is it?
We have Praise by I Am They.
There you go.
Yep.
Wake everybody else up. See you in a sec. All right, good morning to you guys. This is your breakfast show. If you've just joined us right now, you know the breakfast show. We are here every morning from 8 a.m. all the way to 10 o'clock. And today is a Thursday relationship power. I just want to introduce those of our guests, or they make part of the furniture, on the table of justice this morning. Over to my right, we have the one, the only, it's the lady, it's the Wonder Woman herself. It is Selena Green. Good morning, Selena Green. Good morning. Yeah. We need to give a montage. Yeah. We need to give a montage of your antics, your back flipping and all that, like lifting weights and all that stuff. And that's Wonder Woman right there. As well as Wonder Woman beside her, we have the one, the only, the man who's toucan. It is Will I Am. Good morning, I Am Will. Yes. How you doing today, brother?
Oh, I feel so good. I feel so excited to get into the subject matter today.
Dropping like it's hot.
Great. Thank you.
All right. And over to my left side this morning, he's the original Namibian commando. It's the man himself, Ignatius Ango. Good morning. That's your camera right there, brother. That's your people watching you dance. What are you looking at? You're looking them right in the eyes. Oh. That's it. You're passing the vid. You're like, alright, we're good.
Yeah, of course we are here.
That's the spirit.
Pleased to be here.
Absolutely. This is the
delighted.
Fantastic. And also beside the one and only Mr. Hango, the original Namibian commando, we also have coming straight through from the wood to the good to the good to the green to the in from wood green. It's Lady Shirley. Yay. I'm saying
from the good to the green.
I'm telling very powerful. To the green. She'd be dropping bars, you know. Like, no one gonna mess with green, you know. No one messing with green.
They're fiery. They are fiery.
Yeah. Really? Seriously. When Shirley came in the other day, all we see in the live chat was all these green dots. Like people, like literally wood green, like support their people.
Wow.
Look, she got the plan. She don't even have to make effort.
We did.
We're a family.
That's the spirit. All right, guys. So, look, it's Relationship Power Thursday here on The Breath Show, so make sure you wake everybody else up. We're going to go into this right now. We're going to pose our question for today. And the question that we posed, we know we're looking at baggage. We know we're looking at, if you saw the advert, if you're on The Breath Show broadcast, you would have received it. We're looking at the baggage that we have that we can carry secretly, and it harms everybody. It slowly poisons the person that you're with, that you fought for, or they fought for you, and it's affecting them. Mm. And so we want to pose a question to kind of get everyone to look a bit deep. All right, Kat,
yes,
share with us the question for today.
The question for today is
No, we're not doing it. It's a Thursday, Kat. So you're going to put something, you know, something, something. Yep.
Let's try it on myself.
Yeah.
That's more. That's more like
you're hitting that.
All right. So the question for today is, besides unfaithfulness and lying, what baggage or characteristics would you not tolerate and why?
What baggage or characteristics would you not tolerate and why? Okay. Now, I'm curious to see, to go straight to Kathleen, because Kathleen seemed like she like, I got this one.
Yeah.
So let's hear what you have. And please put it in the live chat, guys. You can send a voice note up to maximum 15 seconds. Because when I say 20, everyone does 3 minutes. So 15 seconds. If you want to put your answer in, you don't like typing like I don't. All right. So let's go. Take away the cat. What's your one?
For me, it's in the question, right?
Mm.
A big thing for me is unfaithfulness, but you said not to say.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the second thing would be when they don't like to be near the authority of God, the people of God. When they don't like to be near the pastors, near the assistants, they like to be far away from everyone. That's very strange.
That's a very good one, Kat.
It's very.
It's saying a lot.
Yeah, it says a lot. Like, we're all going to evangelize, right?
Yeah.
In the bus. And then we're at the front of the bus and you're all the way at the back by yourself.
That's a weird sign.
That's weird.
That's a very interesting sign.
Yeah, I don't like it. I don't like it when people are far away from, not people, but like, potential partners are far away from the authority of God.
Yeah, I think we've seen that quite a bit, right? We've seen that happen in Ignatius, right?
It's a red flag.
It's a red flag. Mm-hmm. That actually says a lot.
Yeah.
In fact, it says everything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But I can contribute to that in actual life.
Mm.
When you have a partner,
mm-hmm.
and she from time to time disappear, going to his family or her family, and then she come back, and then he come back,
then he goes.
Yeah.
It's distancing, break is
that's interesting
because what you need is to bond.
Yes, I hear that.
You have to be Ruth.
Yeah,
saying wherever you go, I go.
Yeah,
your God will be my God.
Yeah.
Which means there's no break.
Yeah,
we are there.
That's very interesting.
Yeah.
So we got it like dealing with in a faith environment. This person who probably met you in the faith environment in this scenario,
mm-hmm.
but you can see that they are distant. And then you have when you're with someone that they like to be distant themselves. Yeah. That's a very deep one.
Like switch off.
Yeah.
Then come back.
That's an interesting one.
I want to kind of add to that. It's very true because that is a big red flag. And also when they try to distance you as well from the people of God, the people of faith, when they actually slowly try to make you distance yourself as well, that's a big red flag there as well.
That's a
flaming. There's something hidden, there's something wrong.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, all that just from that one from Kat. that was very interesting.
Yeah.
That was very interesting, right?
Yeah.
All right, anyone else here? Ones that your personal one, Shirley.
The green dot.
By the way, we got even amount of guys and even amount of ladies today, guys, which is very interesting that took place. By the way, before you just go jump into it, Shirley, we have Tyra's green. Gabriella says pride and jealousy. Okay, but let us know why.
Mm-hmm.
Gabriella. Prince says pride and envy. Pride, the person's proud and they have envy. Okay, but let us know why. Yeah, it'd be good to give some context to it. Shirley, what's your one?
I think a really big one to me is when the person's low-key disrespectful. So they're not disrespectful completely, but in small things that they do, you can see disrespect in what they do. So in the way that they speak to people sometimes, in the way that sometimes they'll address themselves with you.
Wow.
I think just disrespect as a whole, but in the small like details. Not because a lot of the times disrespect isn't shown in the relationship as the person's shouting at you in the streets, but it's shown in the small things that actually happen. So the small comments that will come out sometimes, or like, let's say you're at a table with everyone and your partner will address something to you in front of everyone that can be addressed privately, things like this.
Okay,
are very big red flag.
That's a huge red flag. I think that's a really good one, right? Because it's so easy to brush certain things under the rug. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then you see it consistently, all right. And I'm just assuming it's an environment of faith, and you wouldn't. You're checking, but you're checking for obvious things. But this kind of level of disrespect or dishonor can be very subtle. You know, so that's a huge one. My gosh, we're getting psychological today, ain't we? We're getting psychological today. It's like we're going into line 90 professor territory.
Yeah. It's not even 9 o'clock.
It's not even 9 o'clock yet. all right, let me go to you, Will. What's your one? What be your one? I'm curious.
So I tried to choose one of the two words particularly. So I chose baggage. And I thought, okay, what would be something that I wouldn't tolerate? And I was thinking, whatever it is, it would be something that I wouldn't want to do to someone else.
Okay.
Hence why I'd feel like I don't want to tolerate that from you, because I wouldn't put you through it.
Yeah.
So I'd think something that probably irks me is constant comparisons to whoever they dated in their previous relationship.
Oh.
Yeah, I feel like I know it's, some people might think like, oh, that's not even like a norm, but I do know from my own experience, and I know other people being through it as well, is some people are very comfortable and vocal talking about things that happened in their previous relationship a bit too much.
Okay.
Things like that, and that's something that's like, oh
yeah.
So going forward, if I pick up on that, that's something on my radar I couldn't ignore.
that can bring out the tiger in somebody.
I believe in God, but my friend, that's a different version of me. You know, I'm probably going to end up sounding a bit like disrespectful. You know, you never know. But here's something interesting. We've got Yen. Yen is saying from Finsbury Park, FPK 300. Good morning, Breakfast Show. Good morning, Yen. She says, apart from disrespect, also lack of effort and unwillingness to sacrifice to make a relationship work. Effort is needed from both sides. Like you're trying to push forward, but the person's very lackluster. The person, you know, it's like you're coming up with all the ideas, but they're not kind of doing the dance with you to kind of keep that balance. That's a huge one right there. And I think for a guy, I think that's really off-putting, right, Ignatius?
For me, once I see something like that, of course, patience and all that should be applied.
Yeah.
But you have to know that that's a flag there. If he's starting right at the beginning, what do you expect along the journey?
When they have you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, I remember Bishop Massed said that he got just one little thing, and that was enough. The mistake that many of us do, we have that dangerous attitude. I think along the way things will change. This is not that big. That is a sign. That's a sign of a big thing.
That's
so
true.
For you to be safe,
the standard already needs to be set. It's like, okay, I can work with this. But if you see that they're already like, you're having to push the suitcase with stones, you know, like to get them to show any engagement, they're most likely going to be half of that unintentionally in the relationship.
Exactly.
We're getting psychological today. It's not even 9 o'clock. It's like that. So, and you know, but what you always said about disrespect, because I was thinking, like, when I got married, I remember that I was like, you know, going to respect my wife and everything like that. I mean, there's some things she did that I felt she could have done better. And instead of me being like straight up vocal, I would try to be kind, but I noticed that only after I realized it was coming up as being very sarcastic. So I was I was turning what I could be like, you know, into sarcasm, you know? And I think that played against me. You know what I mean? That played against me. Even though I felt like I was in the right, I didn't notice it, you know? So what you're saying about disrespect, and that could have come across disrespectful as well. But I don't see myself going into the relationship disrespectful. So yeah, we have to have both eyes open, isn't it? We have to have both eyes open to balance things out.
Yeah.
So Sabrina, so we had your one. The person's not given, yeah. right? Yeah. And what was your one, Sabrina?
Sorry. Got to correct you there.
Thank you. I was calling her Sabrina. Selena. We've got like S's on the table. Selena, Sabrina. Shirley.
Yeah. Shirley, Selena, Sabrina.
All right. Okay, so Team Power.
I would say something that I can't tolerate is game playing. I don't like the silent treatment. Yeah. If you're in a relationship and you've done something wrong or you're not aware of it and the person holds that silent treatment against you and you're trying to figure out why all of a sudden the change in attitude, why all of a sudden, and the person's just not communicating it to you. That is damaging for me because you're trying to figure out what have I done? What's wrong?
Yeah.
And the person's trying to, you know, kind of tag you along and make you guess.
See you, Shirley.
Which I'm not aware of.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
The person's doing that intentionally to make you guess.
Right.
Yeah.
But if you're not aware, communicate it.
Yeah.
Sit down and tell me, okay, Selena, I didn't like that. That was wrong. Don't hold that silence and for days and weeks.
Silent
and
treatment.
That's
not good.
That's not good at all.
It kills the communication between a couple.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. And then you start to get angry and I'm guilty. I've done it myself. I have done it myself in the past. But I've learned that communication is so important.
Yeah.
And if you're holding something against someone that they did weeks ago.
You know what? Here's something that is, because I'm coming to you. Like another thing I remember, this is after I got married, right?
Right.
I've been guilty of this on and off. Like, and here's the thing. I remember when, once again, my wife did things I didn't like. I explained. Didn't get corrected.
Okay.
And afterwards, I'm like, I'm not going to be a hypocrite. So I justified that behavior at the time by saying, I'm not going to be a hypocrite.
Yeah.
Like, because, as in, so it was me not communicating anymore.
Yeah.
But maybe I'm thinking that maybe I should have continued to voice, like Bishop was sharing with us, like to bring it back and say, look, I put an ultimatum, what we learned in Love Talk, you know, at the time, you know, so it's very interesting.
Yeah, because I mean, it's hard because when you're in a relationship, you start to see things about yourself you didn't realize were there before.
Yeah.
You know? Mm. And when situations happen, you don't really know how you're going to be until they happen.
Yeah.
But when it comes to the silent treatment, you know, it can be damaging, especially when you're holding it for a long time when it could have been resolved.
Yeah.
Earlier on.
But I think also the person might just not be a good communicator.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's that element of it as well, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
It's interesting. Yes.
But a silent treatment is a disease.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
It's in a relationship. I can't.
Yeah.
I like that.
Let everything out and in whatever shape or form.
And when I go to sleep, I sleep like a baby.
That's true.
But when you embark, because before we come to the Lord Jesus, there used to be a silence treatment, like or a switch off. If this is the situation and I don't like
it. I think men are guilty of that a lot. We don't like stress.
Yeah, just take the car key when you hear the car.
We're laughing, but it is what it is. It happens.
It is, right?
The car key and switch to friend for 2 days.
Wow, that's deep.
Then when you come, you expect that silence to kind of been lifted.
Yeah.
To your surprise,
it's still the same. Yeah, I hear that. Yeah. That's strong. That's so really strong.
The key here, no matter how painful, it's good to break the silence.
Yeah.
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 even to watch, to go and watch the play to which you never did in your life. Darling, I'm going to watch the play. No, it's my turn to change the nappy of the baby. Since when?
That's true.
I know, right? Is that baby grown up? He's an adult now. But okay, so anything just to break that gap.
Yeah.
I'm going to come to you now with the one that puts you off. We've got a comment here from Prince from Manchester. He says, for example, is when it comes to apologize or admitting that you are wrong, or the pride to see things from a different perspective. Oof. Envying other relationships, those who are in a different path of a relationship, and then always trying to do the same like others, or even talking about it all the time. That would be annoying, right? You're with someone, they're like, oh, look at those two. Oh, this one doesn't do that. And my friend, I had, oh, this one cooks. This one, I spoke to the wives, this one cooks for that. And I was like, like, man, I don't cook, man. Oh, God, are you signed up to it?
But that's me.
That's me, I don't cook. But we try. I try to do something to give, like.
Because even though you say, yeah, he cook, I don't cook, that's me. In the back of your mind, you say, oh, maybe I should learn some few recipes.
Yeah. Like, I think to be obstinate, to hear that, that's what they like. And to be obstinate, I think that's not fair.
Yeah.
You know, because I think you have to give. You have to give.
I was going to say,
that's a woman's way of saying, you know, I would like you to do the same, you know, in a different way. Yeah.
But I think if it's
now to us, that comes completely different.
Yeah.
Oh, you compare me with.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
It's interesting. We're getting psychological today. We haven't gone to the first element. Yes, Will, you're going to say something.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, comparison is the thief of joy. It's something that is.
I love that.
I don't even blame people for wanting to make comparisons, because I think that's somewhat of a natural thing to do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I suppose when you voice out those opinions, and then you go out of your way to maybe even doing it a bit consistently, this person's doing this, how come you're not doing this, and things like that. I think it's a bit of a demoralizing way to treat somebody, and not just in a relationship. Like, as soon as it was mentioned, it was something that I thought, that's something that in any type of like friendship or colleague or business relationship or anything that you can think of, that's just something that it's very difficult to put up with any kind of person in your life. I think
that's a very good way of putting it. And I think maybe it could be the way they say something, right? Because they might say, okay, this is working for someone, but the way they communicate it to you could be better.
Yeah.
So it doesn't sound like a comparison.
Yeah, because sometimes it doesn't even come across like, this is what you could do to improve. It's almost like you're failing in doing this. You
know what I mean? Because, that actually come, especially in children. You can't do that. Treat them as different as they are. Because once you mention, your old brother is better than you. He used to do.
Yeah. Will's like shaking his head like,
I'm gonna say it. Yeah. And sometimes it's a shame, because it's not even that the kid wouldn't grow up to be as great as their older siblings. Sometimes they just don't reach that level as quickly as maybe the older siblings and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then you've put someone down who, had you not done it, their potential would have skyrocketed, but then they've been thinking that they're not capable, so they don't believe in themselves.
And that's
something that I think translates to all kinds of situations as well.
Yeah.
Powerful. Yeah, right. Thank you so much for that, Prince. Yeah. Anonymous ending 2365 says, for me, it's those that take advantage of good character and those that manipulate others to get what they want, and narcissists. This word gets used a lot in 2024. Especially someone who has too much admiration for himself or herself. That's a tough one.
Oh.
That Wheels like, yeah, okay, I can see how that could work.
Because I think that's true. I've always thought, and this is something I discuss with my mom a lot, I feel like people's identification of what a narcissist is, I feel like it's so wide ranging.
Mm.
So I think it's true, like, you wouldn't want to date a narcissist or be friends with one. But I think some people incorrectly point out certain traits of, like, oh no, you're a narcissist because you stood up for yourself, or oh, you're a narcissist because of this and that. And sometimes you kind of see those traits and then you gloss over it and you make excuses for those people.
Drop it like it's hot. So what was your one, Ignatius? Because about the question for today, all right? Things up besides lying and unfaithfulness, what you can't tolerate.
The character that I mentioned is just that.
Did you say it already? Because we had so many this morning. Right? Yeah.
It's the fact that you're in relationship, but you want to find that vacation.
For
yourself. You switch off for sometimes, then you come back.
Yeah.
Especially when the atmosphere is not good.
Yeah.
The issue of the car key.
You go.
Then you hope to find things
settled.
Yeah.
So the escape artist.
Exactly.
You don't tolerate the escape artist. Look, guys, it's very interesting. All right, these are things people have their reasons for certain behaviors, and sometimes the reason why they behave like this is a negative thing that they're holding on to. Sometimes we can do, being human beings and being imperfect, from what I can understand, we're gonna make mistakes.
Yeah.
But the humble person is able to kind of listen and kind of learn and self-respect. Like in Proverbs, it says there's a way that seems right to a man, but the end leads to death. So we're kind of always examining ourselves and getting better. But speaking about examining ourselves and getting better, we're going to go into our next part now, which is the Love Talks element. So we're going to take a little bit of a breather. We're going to play some music, all right, for you. I've got a TikTok shock, actually, I want to show to you guys before we go into it from this morning. And this one is going to be, I think, oh gosh, yeah, man, we've got some hot ones today. We've got, let's see. Let's go to that. What's that one on the far right? That one. Let me see that one.
That's the video.
That's our video. Okay. So we're going to go to not the kimchi one. Not yet. We're going to save that one when it gets really spicy. What's the other one? Okay. Let's go to the judge. Let's go to the judge. All right. Yeah, the judge lady. Yeah, like that's it. Check this out, guys.
Let me ask you this. You looking for a $100,000 wedding?
Yes.
Why?
I have high standards and I feel like I shouldn't lower them just because.
I have high standards too. I went to a justice of the peace.
Okay.
Married 32 years. The biggest weddings are the shortest marriages, I swear. You know, Kim Kardashian, that dude, 72 days. Took her longer to pick out the dress than it did to be married to her. You know what I mean? You look at, that's just a party. You have that party with, like, on your 25th wedding anniversary, then you can spend that kind of money. $100,000, you're never gonna get married, honey. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. 20,
that's the wrong goal. The goal is to have him, like, for 40 years.
Yeah.
Not to have one party.
The guy speaking up.
Yeah.
He'd be waiting on that.
So someone finally saying what I was thinking.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And he said that.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He got some courage. And the thing is, she justified it with, this is my high standards. It sounds very great. It sounds very honorable. Sounds honorable, you know, but what's the reason behind it? What's
reasons.
The baggage behind
real
it?
Exactly.
Yes.
And the guy's trying to keep the peace.
Yeah. And we just, most of the time, to be honest, majority of guys, we are not saying, I'm not defending them. We can be really mean. But most of the time, just want to keep, let's keep peace.
Yeah. I mean, the lady says high standards.
Yeah. Oh,
I have high standards. As if that's like, yeah, you're right.
I think one thing that came to mind when I saw that was that there's high standards in your character, in who you are.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then some people define their high standards by their material possessions and money.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And I think she's going to let that get in the way of stopping her marrying the man that she wants to be with for the rest of her life. Yeah. It's like she's put that before...
The priorities are upside down.
Yeah. Mm. And like what the judge was saying, you can spend that money later on, maybe on your anniversaries to build
that's,
it.
That's the point. Mm. I remember Bishop Renato telling us that sometimes... the higher standard can be an impediment, because you first have to think behind your higher standard, what are you really bringing into relationship?
The relationship, exactly.
Yeah. Are you know, because the higher standard can be an impediment. It can take a lot and never to bring them back.
Mm. Yeah.
You spend a lot because you want a higher standard. Mm. You demand a lot, but when the person come inside, he doesn't see that higher standard in you.
In other areas of their life or what they do or their stand and their principles, That's very strong. Yeah, that's deep.
They get taken away by the show.
Grandiose.
You know, and yeah.
Well, it's kicking off today, guys. All right. We've got comments here. The comments are kicking up. I'm here. Breakfast Show, What's Up, Lion, and the live chat. We're going to go for a timeout. We need to take a bit of a breather, okay, before we go into the first part of the last week's Love Talk seminar. It's four pieces, which is great. It's less than usual, thank God for that. Because you see Kat's laugh. And we're gonna come back in just a moment. Kat, what song you got for us?
We have This Girl Is Mine by Michael Jackson.
Oh, Michael, lovely. Jackson. Good song, Michael Jackson. That's it. There was an auntie, she says, they were playing Michael Jackson on Liberty Radio. I was like, yeah, it's a perfect. What does that have to do with God? It's a breakfast show. It's a breakfast show. It's a breakfast. You know, we just play music to nice get free for the morning. It's a nice song. Like, what God is? What does that to do with Jesus? Anyway, this is breakfast show. Okay, guys. Caleb and Lorraine, we're going to come back to you. Let's enjoy some, what's it called? That Girl.
This girl, the girl is mine.
The girl, oh, the girl is mine. Classic. Yeah, you go. Let's see the Iron Man's like, yeah. All right, guys, we'll be right back in just a moment. Yeah. Right after this. Hey, guys. I hope you're enjoying the show. Just thought I'd interrupt. If you haven't done already, hit smash the robust like and subscribe button. Why not? Why not? You like us, I like you. Why not? That's right, we're going to have a good day today. This is your Breakfast for Show with Relationship Power Thursday. And the table of justice is full. It's full here. We have, unfortunately, Shirley had to leave us because she had to go on another mission. But we have the one and only, the Namibian commando, Ignatius Hanko, with us this morning. We have the one and only Wonder Woman, the lady Selena Green. I used to call her the general. Well, not a general, but Wonder Woman. Yes. She's a set. And also, we have the one and only, the man who never stays still. I am Will in the house. Good morning, I am Will, and everybody. Yay. Awesome. Look, guys, you know, we were having a discussion during the timeout and about the video that we played. Play it just very quickly, Kat. It looks like we're going to be doing a bit of breakfast overtime today. Hopefully, there's no other show coming up. Check this out.
Let me ask you this. You looking for a $100,000 wedding?
Yes.
Yes. Why?
Oh, you said yes.
I have high standards and I feel like I shouldn't lower them just because.
I have high standards too. I went to a justice of the peace.
Okay.
Married 32 years.
Uh-huh.
The biggest weddings are the shortest marriages, I swear. You know, Kim Kardashian, that dude, 72 days. Took her longer to pick out the dress than it did to be married. You know what I mean? You look at, that's just a party. You have that party with like on your 25th wedding anniversary, then you could spend that kind of money. $100,000, you're never gonna get married, honey. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
20, that's the wrong goal. The goal is to have him like for 40 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it.
All right. Say it,
Josh. Listen, all right. We've got things kicking off here about like Selena said something very interesting because when we were talking during the timeout, Selena went into that moment when she like her eyes go into more reflection and just thinking back on this piece, right?
Yeah, I think about
women having their ways.
Yeah,
and like,
you know, it had to go before a judge to get to the point where she had to realize, you know, maybe.
Did she even realize?
Well, I mean, I was just looking at her face again and she was like, but I don't know if she fully agreed. But why did it have to go before a judge for her to realize that? Because sometimes women, we can be too much.
In having what wanting what they want.
Yes, because I was saying before, there's high standards in your character, who you are, and sometimes women have measured their high standards with material things that can be put aside. And not block her from marriage.
And women know that men want to please them.
Yes,
because you touched. That's where the conversation went.
Yeah, women are quite good at persuading. So,
right?
You know,
it's those kind of natural thing. Understand? Because even bird, you see a little bird, a male bird, going through tough time to impress. You know, the man, he
works hard.
He go to collect some serious wood from far. And the peacock, they have to.
Yes.
You know?
The feathers.
So you even see in nature, the males trying his best to please the female, and the female's like,
Is that the high standard? It's like a thermometer.
Right, and the human race being intellectual, being intelligent, having the brain that we have, women, you said, know how to use that to their advantage.
Yes, yeah, we do, and I think there has to be a point where the woman also has to see, is it worth it?
Yeah.
Is it worth it? Can that money not be spent later on?
But she wouldn't hear it. I know. I've had one in my life for 22 years. And I know there are some things that if you try to explain logically, with logic, they're just in there.
I know.
Like, it's a female thing. Rob,
we are actually privileged.
Yeah.
Because.
Amen. Amen.
Because we have.
God is working.
Apart from us, we have someone who is. In our absence, he work on our behalf.
Absolutely.
I feel pity for men who are out there on their own.
Yeah.
You understand?
Wow. Yeah.
Because there's no one talking to the wife.
Yeah. That's it. Go do prayer and fasting.
I'm not saying that high standards are bad.
No.
I just believe also there's a time for it as well.
Yeah.
But it's not something she should drop.
Yeah.
But there's the time for it.
And we're going to go into the first part, but it's just the way the guy was like, when the judge was in on his side, the man was like, yep, it's going to be £100,000 wedding. He was like agreeing with it. Like, you know.
Then finally.
Like, hostage situation.
Yeah. Hostage. He's aware.
At the end, it's like, yes, you don't need to. We don't need to. All right, you know. All right, anyway, guys, let's stop. Let's keep it moving. All right, this is your breakfast show. I can see the live chat kicking off. I can see Lorraine sharing stuff. Calum Dork says, I think films and things have changed the perceptions of modern women in a lot of respect. With the level of weddings, etc. Obviously, if you have money and can afford to do as you please. But 100k on a wedding, most people who are more serious with each other will put that on the priorities of a couple long term.
Yeah.
Not short term. See, I am Will agrees with that.
Yeah.
Olivia says, good morning. Oh, good morning, Olivia. Great to have you on the show. Caleb says, the man who never stays still, I'll be using that for Will going forward. The man who never stays still, I'll be using that for Will going forward.
That's your guy, Caleb.
Love it. Patience at Finsley Park says, good morning. Oh, and Anonymous Ending 742 says, that video says it all. Why go before someone? A judge, really? If they can't agree on little things like this, sorry, but move on.
Good.
Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? That's them planning their wedding.
Yeah. it's a long way.
Already
before,
got you.
Before you come there, it's a long way.
Already got you in court.
Exactly. You're already in.
Sign of things to come. Okay, guys, let's go start going into the first part there was four, right? Okay, cool. All right, let's have a look at last week's love therapy. Let's go take the notes, keep the communication going, and in a live chat, if you want to send a voice note, send it to the Breakfast Show WhatsApp line, which is on your screen right now, from the one and only Kathleen. What's the number, Kat?
It is +44 75 79 79 6845.
What is that again, Kat?
+44 75 79 79 6845.
All right, that's for you to connect with us from wherever you are on the globe using the WhatsApp platform. All right, don't go anywhere. Let's keep it going. Anonymous Ending 742 said, "Celebs are selling a dream, not reality." I think that's bouncing off what Caleb said. Yeah, it's true. All right, let's go into this number one. Take it away.
The Bible says that the mercies of God are new every morning. When you start to get to know someone, when you start dating someone, you are making a commitment that every night you reset the bank of forgiveness. Amen. Because being in a relationship with someone is knowing that you're going to get upset, hurt all the time. But Bishop, become hurt all the time. The person wants to hurt me. No, but listen. sometimes you hurt people without them knowing, or without you knowing you hurt them, and vice versa. Sometimes people hurt you without you knowing that, or without them knowing that they were hurting you. We hurt each other because we're human. Is it true or not? So sometimes you're saying a word that is very well intentioned, but it ends up hurting the person. When you are in a relationship, you need to make a conscious decision, an understanding that every night at midnight, the clock of forgiveness is reset. Remember the story of Cinderella. She was dressed as a princess, but in reality, she was a maid. And at midnight, her princess clothing would disappear at midnight. Maybe this is not the best example, but in relationships, every day, you have to be okay with, okay, today this person upset me. All right, you go to bed, tomorrow's a new day. When you wake up in the morning, you kiss that person. If you are married, you sleep with them in the same bed, okay? Did you get it? Okay. So you sleep in the same bed, of course. So at night, something happened, you're upset during the day. The next morning, when you wake up, the clock has reset. So you kiss the person as if nothing happened the day before. Amen.
Yeah, we're not talking about violence, okay? When my husband says, hurt each other, is what I often say to some singles when I am talking to someone who's single, is that you can't be sensitive. To be with someone is like the mirror. We've learned about that. So you have to be ready to see, to look at the truth. And you may feel hurt that way.
Because maybe you don't do this. Maybe you keep things, you hold on to things, or you think, relationships that are of God, you're not supposed to upset each other. Maybe any little thing that happens, you shout abuse, you shout all, and sometimes it's not abuse. It's just that, you're human. You upset the person, and we have to let things go, learn to let things go. If you in a relationship, or if you as a person, you don't have this habit of letting things go, you cannot be in a relationship. It's not going to last. And if it lasts, you're going to be bitter. So learn to every day at midnight, or every night at midnight, you reset the clock. When you're upset with someone, just wait until 5 to midnight, and then you say, you're lucky that at midnight the clock resets.
Yeah, but if you can, don't wait until midnight, because you've wasted a whole day that you will never get back in your life.
It's a figure of speech, No.
All right. You see that piece there? That should be played on repeat for all couples or anyone thinking about being in a couple.
Yeah.
Anyone. Like literally... Is it? Okay. Everybody. I mean, the fact that I like what he says, like, just because you have God, you're not supposed to be upset with each other. Honestly speaking, I that it's not going to be straightforward. But at the same time, you think you're surprised when you're upset with each other. I don't know, mate. I think I was naive. I think during our time, we didn't have love therapy like it is now.
Yeah,
right, Selena?
Right. Yeah.
And I think it's just keeping it real. Mm. Right, Ignatius? Mm.
Yeah.
Drop it like it's hot. Beautiful.
You're marrying another human being.
Yeah.
You know, and like Mrs. Helena said, it's a mirror of yourself.
Yeah.
Are you prepared for that?
Yeah.
Maybe we were not so... Maybe, when we entered into marriage, we thought everything was going to be rosy.
Yeah.
But we were not maybe thinking of the other side as well, that you're going to have to see who you really are.
Yeah.
You're going to have to receive
feedback. No one
feedback.
Tells us that at the time.
You're going to have to get feedback, right? Yeah. You're ready for feedback.
It's so important because marriage is a one way. It's just like life.
Mm.
It's like it's not like you've been born, die, and come back again.
Mm.
It never happened. Everything we do in marriage is one way.
Yeah.
It's not that you get your first born, then you change, you go back and get him again. No.
Yeah.
So we learn as we go.
Yeah.
And remember, you are taking someone's daughter, someone's son.
Yeah.
And they are different from you, apart from love you have between the two of you.
That's right.
So The mirror in the wall is the best thing, but you also have to have the heart to say, yes, I'm wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think that's pushed enough, right? Mm-hmm. Because we're kind of taught what to require from a person, mm-hmm. but it's not stressed that, you know what, this person's going to reveal who we really are.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That, as far as I know, has never been said before. We're usually kind of protecting ourselves, mm-hmm. our future, mm-hmm. by looking for the right person. Mm-hmm. But we're right. not, and as far as we know, we're not a bad person.
Mm-hmm.
We know our intentions mm-hmm. are good,
mm-hmm.
but we don't understand that maybe it comes across of what we say is outputted in a very bad way, or is not received well by the other person's mind or by the other person's standards.
Because your character, her character
is different.
Yeah.
So if you're trying to merge it and it's not, so she yeah. have to say and he have to say too. So the two of you have to make sure that there's this.
Do you know people go into old age and only find out about that level of humility, right? They yeah. after like bumping yeah. their head so many years, and yeah. I've seen videos where the lady say, yeah, we've been married for 5 to 6 years, and I just realized I ain't gonna change him. Don't try to change him.
You see?
They're so relaxed when they say it, but yeah. it's like, it took us years to find that out. Yes, and the love took you getting it for free.
The absence of love therapy in the world is detrimental to many relationships.
Yeah.
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 I think also what's nice about the love therapy is that the pastors and the bishops have gone through years of the experience themselves
yeah.
and are now able to pass that as well to yeah. us, you know?
Yeah. It's real.
Yeah, it's real.
It's real.
It's real.
It's experience that comes from both the altar yeah. and the relationship.
That's yes. true.
So the mixture of that is real. There's no, it's not a show.
No.
But you know, the beauty of it is that there has to be that, from the altar, that humility.
Yeah.
Right, because to find a way out, there has to be humility to be like, oh, I'm messing up here, mm-hmm. or you know what I mean, because there's a saying I've always loved that smart is the one who learns from their own mistake,
mm-hmm.
wise is the one who learns from somebody else.
Exactly.
So from the altar, it's like we're getting a mixture of the two. We're getting their smart
yes.
mistakes that they made, and mm-hmm. also wise mistakes where everyone's learning off each
yeah,
other.
That's right,
you know,
that's right.
Where the source is the author of love. Mm-hmm. And this is good. This is yeah. safety.
It's brilliant.
I'm yeah. looking at you like you're gonna, you know, young man coming up. You know what I'm saying? Like this is great, man.
My friend, you have the diamond mine.
Yeah. Look, man, if I get a chance to MC a wedding, man, I'm looking forward to it.
Trust me. If Robert will be there, I'll be there.
Yeah.
if Serena will be there and Kat will be there, we will be there. If one of us will be there, trust me, that's you'll it. Get all of us.
Just take a fruit. Yeah. Just take a fruit of love for. Take a fruit of love therapy.
Exactly.
Okay, hey, we're gonna go for our next part, number two. It's gonna get deep, it's gonna get rough, it's gonna get raw. This is your breakfast show, and you know the score. Take it away, Kat.
Sometimes people are very worried about curses.
Yeah.
Ah, Bishop, someone put a curse on my love life, and curse and witchcraft and so on. If you're in the presence of God, the only curse you have to be worried about is not the curse someone puts on you, because you are protected against that curse. The only curse you should be worried about is the one you bring to yourself. Yeah. Like it's written here. For they have taken some of what? They have taken some of the accursed things. If you are faithful to God, then no curse in this world can touch you. Bishop Renato is one of the main bishops of the church. He started the UCKG in the UK, started the love therapy seminars the way that we have today. And then he said, he put a picture of him and his wife on social media, and he wrote, later tonight, we'll be making a very important announcement. Live. And within an hour or two, there were something like 600 comments. You would expect Bishop Renato making that announcement and him being a bishop and that being his social media. Who follows him? People of the church. Christians, right? And then I went to read the comments. My friend, I was very sad. There were people saying there, oh, they will announce that they're getting divorced. People were writing there as if they were looking forward that this was going to happen. A lot of the comments were comments of this nature. Not to mention those who never wrote anything, because you know that the minority write, but many think but don't write. And this made me think how many of the 1.2 million people who follow him on YouTube, how many follow him because they want to see him fall? And for the dismay and sadness of these people, what was the announcement they were going to make? They were going to talk about the love walk. That's the announcement. But even with the tens and hundreds of thousands of people who don't like them, who envy them, who are just waiting for them to fall, they are still what? Mm-hmm. Standing. Because the curse is not what comes from outside. The curse is what you bring in. That's what destroys a relationship. And the Lord Jesus spoke about this, Elena. The Lord Jesus said that what defiles a man is not what comes in, but what goes out. Because what goes out is what is already inside.
Like it happened when we read the comments. Many people's hidden sin was envy for their marriage. So guess what? An opportunity presented itself. Probably they were like, oh, what have I just done? I can't undo what I did. Guess what? It was revealed right there, the hidden sin. Probably they're not happy in love. You see?
The truth is that any sin, any accursed thing that you bring in, what we learn with Achan, is that every sin has consequences. It's not like God is punishing you, like some people say, Bishop, God is punishing me for my sin. No, God doesn't punish anybody. God has better things to do than to be punishing people who do. The truth is that when there is a negative consequence of sin, it's just that, it's consequence. Everything in life is consequences. Your life today is a consequence of what you did 5 years ago, what you've been doing the past 10 years. You plant, the Bible says, everything we plant, we will what? We will reap. If I want to have a healthy marriage tomorrow, I need to plant a happy marriage today.
Wow, that is absolutely powerful. What you sow, you'll reap. Right? How many times have we heard, it's been heard, been said that people are very superstitious, right? And they say, oh, you know what? There's a generational curse. Or, oh, you know what? Everything goes wrong for me. Or, oh, this person said this and now it's failing. Don't get me wrong. There are spiritual things that can happen. But I think like Bishop said, what I'm learning today from what Bishop said is that the blessing or the curse comes from inside of us. Even if somebody did a whole heap of Obia, wherever, on 10,000 mountains or wherever, or like in Bishop's case, you had how many people that are secretly looking for you to fail, it won't touch you because you're grounded in the author of love. You've taken care of yourself inside. So once again, we're kind of learning that it really starts from us, right? Mm-hmm. Success or failure starts from us. The power's in our hands.
Because I remember before coming to the Lord Jesus, there were a lot of things happening. People were saying a lot, like cursing words, oh, it won't last, it's just a matter of time.
Wow.
Oh yeah, we had those, it's too good to be true, wow, and so on. But it's actually started to really affect us until we came to God.
Mm-hmm.
When we came to God, we know those things are happening outside there, but we know for sure, like Bishop said, that it won't affect us as long as we are applying the principle of the altar.
Yes.
That came from the love therapy.
So the author of love is like a bubble. He's like a shield that guards your relationship. And the only way that shield can get destroyed or spoiled or has a hole in it is if inside... we are spoiled and corrupt.
Kind of think, why do people feel like that towards you in the first place? You kind of think, what has happened to them, or what has been happening to them, that they just are hoping for something bad to happen to somebody else? Mm. You know, you think
them are wicked.
No, that's what Bishop Miss Elena said. It's the key to that is because people know that they themselves, they'll never have a love that you have.
Yeah.
They something is wrong with their love life, and they know it. So instead of looking to themselves and trying to do things to better their life, they grow evil eyes against those who they see. And especially when you are not protected by the power of God, then their eyes will be really be on you and things start happening.
Well, how do you feel about that? I mean, like, we had Bishop, like, literally, from what I've seen, Bishop's only done good for people. And then you have this audience, and among them, there are people who are, like, looking to see, like, they're excited, you know, to see something go wrong, to hear bad news.
Yeah.
You know, what are your thoughts on that?
I was going to say, when we was going through it, I'm sure you know, like, I turned to you when it was like, oh, the announcement was literally just the most...
It's good, great news.
Yeah, like, you know, it was going to be the love walk, but it was literally something that was so far from the dramatic that everyone tried to conjure up. And I turned to you because I literally thought, and because I had that epiphany in that moment, like, that's a representation of what people's mentalities are like. Because when Bishop mentioned, that there was this announcement, like, oh, we're going to announce something later on tonight, I literally assumed it was going to be something that was somewhat minor. But then, you know, and that's not because necessarily I have a perfect mentality, but that's literally because I just really assumed, like, it wouldn't be anything crazy, and they weren't going to do some...
Yeah, it's just a simple announcement.
Like, I didn't think it would be, like, some dramatic celebrity, like, oh, we're going to announce that we're going to get divorced. But just letting you know that in a few hours time we're going to do that. Like, and I think, honestly, that's something that is... that I think is people's minds kind of getting corrupted by the kind of celebrity culture we have. People are used to this stuff, like... Oh, you know, celebrities are constantly letting us in on their lives. You know, sometimes they do things like announcements and this and that. So we're anticipating this crazy news. And when our Bishop said that, oh, he was sad, I knew straight away it was people saying things like, oh, they're going to announce that they're splitting up.
Yeah.
I knew straight away that it was going to be that type of comments that he must have been reading.
That's very interesting you said that, because we are kind of conditioned to think like that as well in terms of social media and the media. There's always some big announcement. When there's a big announcement, there's always a million, 2 million pound divorce settlement going on. And that's all we're seeing. So no one was thinking godly in that moment. Everyone was thinking towards, like, what they see.
Clickbait as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
People love drama.
Yeah.
Human beings love drama.
I saw something quite recently. I think it was this week here. I can't remember what medium I saw it on, but someone said our society thrives on either conflict or watching other people engage in conflict. And I've been thinking about it for the last few days, and I'm thinking, like, so many things that I enjoy, without even realizing it, some of that actually is people doing battle. So, like,
I
say people who I love football. I love people watching football, but a sense of that is even though it's not people doing anything horrible to each other, but it's like two forces of kind of going against each other. One's trying to beat the other, one's trying to be the winner, and it's like, and you know, I'm thrilled on that. I don't even need to be out there playing, and I can still get that sort of fix of, like, supporting someone, like, winning, things like that. And that's maybe a bit more of a minor example, but other people like stuff where, oh, their favorite celebrity is having an online feud with another celebrity. It's like, oh, this is my cup of tea. I can't wait to get and chat to my friends about this and that. I think people love, and people love it. They can't get enough of it.
Human beings are strange, man.
It's actually amazing to see that, the world is being intrigued into so-called love for negative. In actual fact, is the attack on the only institution that keep the society going, which called marriage and family.
That's true.
Without knowing, this institution of marriage has been attacked from both corners of the society.
Yeah.
And even us, sometimes, if we are not careful, we will be supporting. You know, people call themselves Christian, but in the back of their mind, maybe they are divorcing.
Yeah.
It's funny you should say that. We actually have a it's gonna go deep now. The one to the far left, Kat. Yeah, we actually have a TikTok about this. People who claim to be godly people, they have standards, but godly standards only when it suits themselves. Mm. Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. Why? Because they have baggage that maybe others can see and others don't. Mm-hmm. But they want to be happy in love. But they've got literally, their baggage is secular reasoning, which can actually harm any potential partner. So we've got a TikTok shock shock to show this right now. And the lady calls her out. Don't get me wrong. It's just a conversation we're looking at. All right. Take it with a pinch of salt. All right. But check this out.
Black women are not bosses. I'm sick of the narrative that black women are strong, independent.
I didn't say strong, independent. Well, we're
not, a man does not want a woman who says she's a boss.
No man.
They respect you as your singer, and they're pandering because of your talent. But are they taking you home and saying, that's my wife?
Somehow.
There's a difference.
Somehow. That's a
between your art and being a wife. Because the Bible, you talked about being a Christian, but it says the older women need to teach the younger women, and younger women need to be submissive. But you know how many young women are not submissive to what men say? But you say you're a Christian woman. Okay. You can't be a Christian woman and buck against what men are saying. That is anti-biblical, it's anti-God, it's anti-Christ, and it makes you the great, great Babylon.
I'm going
to
be honest with you.
But don't claim Christianity if you're not willing to submit to what men are telling you. A lot of women are Christian feminists. So you claim Christianity when it works in your favor, but you put down men and say, you're rebellious. You are anti-Christ, and you are the Jezebel.
She's speaking nothing.
Oh, gosh. Yeah. Okay, now,
I was gonna say that was it was a bit forceful. The way she conveyed it was pretty harsh. There, I can't lie.
It was edited.
Yeah. I mean, you could tell it was a bit clipped and that.
Don't
but
know what she said either.
Yeah, exactly.
I think that there's a bit of a clue there when she said to her, when she replied to her, when she was that when the other lady was speaking, and she said to her lady with the blue hair that only if they can handle women. Only if they can handle us, because they're insecure. If the man's not insecure, he can handle us. Do you know what I mean? That's the secular rhetoric, right? They handle us. Like I don't want to have to handle a woman. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. To put up a woman. I want peace in my life, man. Like, Selena, you're a very ambitious lady. I mean, your thoughts on that? We're talking about baggage today, baggage that can harm the other person. Yeah. Mm. And this is women. This is the boss babe, which sounds good, but maybe it's different.
There's something that I will never ever forget. Years ago, when a bishop's wife said to me that a woman's beauty is in her submission.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I will never ever forget that.
Wow.
That's something I actually carry with me, because we have women know we have power.
Yeah. £100,000 wedding.
That's
we do.
The truth.
We do. And I don't know if you were in the service a few years ago when it was Pastor James doing the service, and he was saying, why does God ask the woman to submit? It's because actually to make us in agreement with the husband.
Mm.
And sometimes we can go forward too much in what we want all the time, what we want, rather than what's going to actually work.
Yeah.
And sometimes we can get carried away with so much noise that's out there now.
Yeah.
Robert.
Yes, soldier living God.
Robert, this show is big.
Do you know what? One thing I must say, like you said, I'm ambitious. Right now I'm single.
Yeah.
There's going to have to become a point where I'm going to have to make some sort of sacrifice.
That's right.
I'm ready for that. So there's going to have to become a point where I may not be able to travel as much as I like to. So I'm going to have to do that. Am I ready for that? And a lot of women, they're not aware of that. And they're not asking themselves, am I ready to make those sacrifices?
And I think I'm going to come to you. And I think what you said is they're not aware.
Yeah.
Right. There's a rhetoric, there's a baggage that's been put in men and women, particularly in this area, because it looks like a good thing.
Yeah.
But when it comes to this, the arena of relationship, it actually messes up the relationship.
That's right.
Right?
That's
right. In terms of roles, in terms of where people position themselves, like a business, right? Yeah. They're boss babe, but they try to be a boss babe in the relationship
and say
they're godly as a wife.
Yeah.
It's strong things.
It can be damaging. I've seen it affect many marriages, especially when I was in the US.
Mm.
I did see that a lot. I mean, the woman was the boss, you know?
Wow.
And it was quite humiliating for the man
especially when you would see her humiliate him in front of everybody as well. Embarrassing. I was very embarrassed for the husband.
That's tough.
Yeah.
Ignatius.
Before I come to Serena, the lady on in the video trying to be in the place of Christian, forgetting that to be a Christian, you have to be taught, molded, helped to change from the creature of God to a person of God.
Mm.
If you come like she was coming, you're not helping.
Mm. It's true.
There's a way there to help the other lady, but not the way she was saying.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. But I think, because I think I saw a bit more of that conversation, and I think there was a lot of obstinance from the lady with the blue hair.
Yeah.
She, as in, like, she only, all she could hear or understand was her red. Because I've got money, because I make my own money in the way that I want.
Yeah.
I this is how I am. I am the boss.
Yeah.
I'm a boss, babe. I'm the boss. So, but I want a man, and he needs to acknowledge my success, which is good.
Yeah.
He needs to, you know, he needs to be able to handle me when I give him attitude.
Yeah.
You know, I'll put him in his place.
Yeah.
Literally, that was the vibe.
Exactly. Mm. To be a man who fit the closet, just to be there.
Yeah.
And that just there.
Because she doesn't need him.
Because she doesn't need. Now, when it's come to women, it's true, they are stronger.
That's
they are powerful.
Right.
Many men who opt to suffer, they can decide to go head on head with women.
Yeah.
It means that you suffer. Why? When you get older, you need a wife, you need children.
Yeah.
And when women of the world, when the children grow, she's a boss. If she was the business and the children grow,
mm-hmm.
and the man doesn't find the way to kind of obey, he's out for good. Now, God help us to put everything together.
Mm.
It's a successful woman, a woman of God, who understand the value that she need to keep both the business, the husband, and the children.
Mm.
Outside.
Yeah, that's if she has a godly mindset,
exactly.
right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Because you can't wear the t-shirt and then have a different mindset.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. All right. I think it's hard enough, man. Yeah. It's hard enough. It sounds good. But I'd say huge good morning to Matthew Raymond over there in South London, the original Batman, who's enjoying the conversation. All right, guys. Let's keep it going. Zila over there in from Finsbury Park, Portuguese and England flag. Great to have you with us this morning. Let's go. And it's okay. You know Zila. Yeah, Zila's your people. Nice. All right, let's go on to the next part, number tres.
Sometimes people are very worried about curses.
Yeah.
Ah, Bishop, someone put a curse on my love life, and curse and witchcraft and so on. If you're in the presence of God, the only curse you have to be worried about is not the curse someone puts on you, because you are protected against that curse. The only curse you should be worried about is the one you bring to yourself. Like it's written here. For they have taken some of what? They have taken some of the accursed things. If you are faithful to God, then no curse in this world can touch you. Bishop Renato is one of the main bishops of the church. He started the UCKG in the UK, started the love therapy. Just for us to finish, look what the Bible says here. Isaiah 10:27, it shall come to pass in the day that his burden will be taken away from your shoulder. This is what we did today. And his yoke from your neck, and the yoke will be destroyed because of the anointing oil. We are going to give that anointing oil on the 28th in all our churches. But the anointing oil doesn't take away your sin. What makes you to overcome your sin is for you to abandon your sin. The greatest sin of Achan was not taking only what he took, was hiding. Because in hiding, He was mocking God, like Elena said. He's like, oh, Joshua can't see me. God can't see me as well. Joshua cannot see, could not see, but who saw? God. Bishop, I'm single. What does this have to do with me? Listen, you who are single, stop thinking that you can deal with the accursed things when you meet someone. Some people think, okay, I'm single. When I meet someone, I let go of my vices. When I meet someone, I deal with my, you know, my hidden sins. No, you need to deal with that now. Because if you wait to meet someone to deal with those things, it's not fair on that person. You're lying to them. You're selling something that is not true. You're selling yourself in the wrong way. You're selling yourself as a person of God when you've never been a person of God.
You are never happy. It's working. Because the single is not dealing with their hidden sins. Even though they get married, they will never be happy because there's something there that is not from God. Simple as that.
It's like the example we give here many times, and I'm going to give again because this is pertinent to this service. A lot of people, I've counseled many couples who had this problem. The guy had an addiction to pornography. And then he used to think, oh, I only have an addiction to pornography because I'm not married. I don't have anyone to sleep with, to have sex with. When I get married, my needs will be met. There will be no reason for me to be addicted to pornography anymore. Do you know what happens? 10 times out of 10, not 9 out of 10. 10 times out of 10. Do you know what happens? A person gets married and they take the pornography into the marriage. That person doesn't know, is it fair on her? Because any sin that is hidden and is not dealt with, you're going to carry that for the rest of your life. Unless you come clean. And you don't have to come clean to me. If you're single, don't come clean to me. Come clean to who? To God. Deal with that and overcome it.
Yeah.
But if you are in a relationship with someone, you have to come clean to that person. You have to. But Bishop, God already fully forgave me. Amen. But that person has to have the choice. Whether to forgive you or not. Hopefully they will. In Jesus' name they will. But you have to come clean. What's better than coming clean? What's better than coming clean? Having nothing to come clean about. Amen.
Amen.
Better than clean confessing is having nothing to confess. Did you get that? Sure. Amen. So, if you have an accursed thing, make a decision tonight to get rid of that. Bishop, I have time because I'm single. I'm not planning to start dating for another 2 years. So, in 2 years, I'll let go of this thing. But you are destroying the most important relationship of all, that is your relationship with God. You don't understand that. The person that is the people around you don't know, can't see, but God can see. You, the most important relationship you are destroying. So get rid of that accursed thing. And if you are in a relationship and there is an accursed thing, you're going to have a difficult conversation. That's a decision you need to make. If something goes wrong, don't come and blame me. But you have to deal with that thing, because otherwise, sooner or later, that will come to the surface, and it will be more painful even.
Powerful. Absolutely powerful.
That's the reality.
Say again?
That's the reality.
That's the reality. Yeah. As real as it is what it is, that's the thing about love talk. And just to give a good bit of context, because one of the segments were missing, basically it was leading up to this, because I know it seemed very strong what Bishop was saying. It's like he went from like 10 to 100, right, from the previous slip. But it was a bit in the middle, and it was given a reference to the Bible situation of Joshua, you know, when they were going into the promised land and God was with them, and they went, they took over Jericho. God was with them. They had a great victory because Jericho was massive, impenetrable walls, but they beat it. But then guess what? They went over to the next, to go to the next place, part of the promised land, a small place.
Aye,
small. But guess what? People died and they were put to run. And when they went to see, wait, what's going on here? What's happening with this? And basically, God revealed to them that, you know what? This guy called Achan, he's basically, I told you guys not to touch anything from that place. Don't touch anything from Jericho. Don't take anything, all right? Don't touch it. But he went, took the accursed things for himself. And so because he did that, no one saw what Achan was doing, but it affected all of Israel. Everybody died. People lost the battle. It was discouraging. So everything went wrong because of this one guy and his secret hidden, as it gave, accursed thing that he was keeping. And so he gave reference to that. That's how it can be in our relationship. We could be a single person. We have hidden things that we are doing, but that's just a monster waiting to destroy our relationship life. Because guess what? Everybody wants to take the promised land. Everybody wants to go and win. Everybody wants to succeed. But if we have those things with us, that's what we're learning today, is that like what happened with Israel and Joshua, we could be getting beaten up by the situation, expecting God to be with us, claiming to be godly, but no, God sees what's actually going on, right?
Indeed. Because the tonic that that Achab took, it was a little thing, easy to be hidden, and no one knows.
Yeah.
But it was a stumbling block. Mm-hmm. It cost life. It caused delay, progress,
yeah,
life, peace, and eventually it wiped off the whole entire family of Achab.
Yeah.
Because we might say that, no, I'm okay, I'm clean, I'm smart.
Mm. But God sees everything.
Yeah.
This is strong. So imagine, this is a perfect mirror towards relationship. I would say, we got the capital sins, but even when you're in a relationship, it could be small things as well. Small things that we keep in our heart. Things that we can say that we've literally breached the line that God has given to us, and literally destruction's coming on us. Like I've said before, behaviors, thoughts, mentalities that we can have, like we saw in the previous one. Yes, Selena.
Yeah, I just remembered a few years ago when the Rahab had a special course for women. It was self-awareness course. Mm-hmm. That was a blessing for me.
Okay.
Because it touched on points that were painful.
Mm-hmm.
And you really had to dig deep each week into an issue, something that you had to be aware of,
yeah,
in yourself.
Yeah.
So you're not looking at anyone else. You're actually looking at yourself.
Wow.
And then I began, after I finished that course, I realized, It starts with me.
Yeah.
Everything starts with me and my relationship with God, and the decisions that I make and the intentions that I have. So I really had to dig deep and realize, okay, what are the things that I have to get rid of that I don't want to take into my next relationship?
Mm-hmm.
So everything started with me. It was painful,
mm-hmm,
but I had to do the work.
Yeah.
I actually had to do the work and not be afraid to face it.
So we got double-edged sword here. So we got the person who's in a relationship, right? That's a danger of causing this, causing harm, right? And we're learning to deal with it. And we've got the person who's single. And obviously, when you're single, nobody sees you, right? But they have things to deal with.
Yeah.
And what you're saying is that, you know what? I realize that, okay, I realized, because sometimes we don't realize that we need to work on these things.
Yeah.
I'm going to come to you, Will, but I want to show you a very nice animation here from a very interesting character called Pepe Le Pew. All right, Pepe Le Pew is a character. Those of you who are from that generation, it was a Warner Brothers character, and he's actually a skunk. He's a skunk. However, he came across another creature that looks like a skunk, but is not a skunk. But one thing about Pepe Le Pew, he is very romantic, and he's looking for love. And maybe this is us as a single person trying to find a godly person, and we have Achan thing hidden, or this is us in the relationship with our partner, and these things are happening. Check this out.
Tiptoe from your pillow to the shadow of a willow tree, and tiptoe dans les tulips avec moi. Bonjour, Monsieur Frog. Comment allez-vous this fine morning?
So everybody knows something's up.
In flowers will stray. This our world's alright.
Even nature can see something's up.
In the garden, in the moonlight, will you pardon me, Gontito? Don't let two lips avec. Hey! Lady, feminine, female, girl, skunk. In the spring, a young man's love lightly turns to thoughts of fancy.
He's got the lyrics.
Your guard up, chérie. Hello, young lover.
Whoever
you are, I am Pepe Le Pew.
It's polite.
Everyone should have a hobby, don't you think? Mine is making love. You are a girl, I am a boy.
Sign all right.
We have all that in common, darling. May I call you darling? You may call me streetcar because of my desire for...
Yep.
I get a kick out of her. Hey, Lolita! Intimacy is difficult and this is strange.
So the person comes love therapy, yeah?
Leave hand.
Yes.
Flirt.
So he just, he had no idea, right? He had no idea. There was something up with him, which was his nature at the time, because he's a skunk, right? But he wants to go for someone who's not a skunk, and it's just not working. There's conflict because of that. What did you read into that, Will?
Yeah, it's funny because it kind of just ties into what we spoke about just before that. It was a self-awareness. Yeah, you know, sometimes obviously that's a super dramatic example, but yeah, sometimes that we can have a capacity where we just don't read the room. So in some ways it'll be a red flag that you're just refusing to recognize as red. Yeah. In other senses it'll be someone making it quite clear that they're not interested in you the way that you are interested in them. You should let that go, pursue something else, but then you're still just kind of holding on.
Yeah.
You're still trying to force that to make it work when it's quite obviously not going to work.
Yeah.
Because obviously a relationship can't really
force.
It can't flourish if one person is trying to do, and obviously that's not even a relationship, but still, but just in general, you know, if one person's got their foot in and the other person's got both feet out, it's not going to work, and that's not even a relationship there. So how's that going to become anything?
And it's interesting in Asia is that so all those points that Will just said, but the person has something with them, right? For example, if we support a godly spin on it, it's as if the person is. They want to have a godly relationship, but they have that smell from things that their vices that they haven't got rid of yet, and they're wondering why isn't it work, or why is it we're always having problems in relationship life, right?
It's amazing because sometimes human being can be in denial, a lifelong denial. We don't realize who we are. But on top of that, we think high of ourselves.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
I'm the man. You know.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
You know. There's nothing I lack. You know.
Yeah. They need to change.
Not me. Yeah. That's the issue. And that's what the love therapy does to us, to do introspect.
Yeah.
And really, really, it's a serious one in a very peaceful God's way to sit on your
it's
own.
It's a safe environment.
Yes. And really realize that you need change. You need help. You need to listen. You need to start all over again.
Yeah.
You need to get rid of things.
Yeah.
You need to get rid of the tannic. You don't need to be a cub. So those kind of things is hard for human. We need a supernatural teaching which comes from thereafter.
Wow. Selena, I mean, it's easy to spot things or to see or to sense the bad smell in somebody else.
Yes.
Very easy, right? Right.
Yes. I love what Sister Ignatius just said, that supernatural teaching. In the world, they don't have that.
So what do they go to for reference? They go to the media. They go to celebrities for reference of how they should be. Yeah. And when you get the godly teaching, it's completely different. Mm. And it does make you look at yourself.
Yeah.
So just as an example of the cartoon, he thought he was the man.
Yeah.
You know, he couldn't see anything else. No. He just saw he's the man, and the other animal must like him.
Mm.
You know, you must like me because I'm the man.
Mm.
He didn't give her any space to talk. any space to communicate anything. Was no, you must have me.
Yeah.
That can be very off-putting for a woman.
Yeah, and you know, and if he started to think, he'd be like, wait, everybody's acting like this. Okay, let me see what's right. happening with me. And I think there's even one carton where he actually went and got perfume, you know, and he was like, he was complete.
He was very
desirable. Yeah. But guess what happened? The cat now went and made herself stink. And he was like, he just wasn't having it with the cat. He was like, nah, you know. So it seemed, I think this is what the importance of having the author of love, right? We're learning so much today, and it's easy for us to spot things that are not right. But I think that the complexity is that as human beings, we are far from perfect.
Indeed.
Yeah.
We are so far from perfect. We're learning every day, and the love therapy and the things that we learn are absolutely awesome to help us self-reflect. And the author of love, like what you said, if we spend time with the author of love and we meditate on those things, we start to work on ourselves, and he helps us, like what you said, to speak with the other person. And if we're not careful, if we don't take care of our vices, you know, and listen to the author of love, we could just be bringing more problems, right?
It's also a sense of sincere and honest, because when you have a nature that you don't see, you need to be sincere and honest when people are telling you.
Yeah.
Because you can put a perfume, but it's still there.
Yeah.
Until you get rid of it, but you can't get rid of it without realizing. You have to realize that this is me. I have an odd.
Yeah.
So I have to listen and given the way how to get rid of it permanently.
Drop it like it's hot. Not
trim it off.
Yeah, drop it like it's hot. This is absolutely beautiful. It's been a great conversation today. I want to say a huge good morning to Elliot. He's been tuned in over in the Netherlands, saying everything that is in the dark needs to be put in the light. Drop it like it's hot. Yeah. The message today in the love talk was absolutely powerful, something for us all to learn and to meditate on, to put into practice for those of us who are in a relationship, you know, to be the change that we want to see, to be an example as well. Maybe you have a partner that they're not on the same wavelength, and you're wondering how you know, they might have their things that they need to work on. First, you know that we're not perfect. That's what we're learning. And also, if we're doing it because of the author of love, then he's going to support us. He's going to direct. He's going to inspire us. He's going to speak with them, which is the important thing. Because if we don't have the author of love, guess what? We're doing it only by our own arms. And this is a lot of work. It's hard work, man. Nobody can do that.
Yeah. No.
Don't wish that on nobody. All right. So, guys, it's been great. I hope you've enjoyed the show this morning. Have we got one more show? One more TikTok shot, seeing as we're doing a bit of overtime. All right, here's a question. There's this guy who's in prison. All right. There's a guy who's in prison. And, you know, firstly, I want to know why he ended up in prison. But the reaction is, why is he so happy about his reaction to his wife? Check this.
Go to jail from your girl.
Yeah, say that again.
Oh my goodness, that was the title when you go to jail.
I can't believe it.
To break from your girl. Oh man.
You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know what's going on up in there, but the guy goes as far as ending up in jail, literally just to escape the situation. And, you know, and the lady wants him. But really, he's like, I need to get out of here, mate. All right. It's an extreme example, but just showing why with a bit of humor, why this stuff is really important. Right? And hopefully that won't be the case with any of us, that someone close to us will have to take such an extreme case because of us. You okay, Gracious? Yeah, it's extreme. Our breakfast show, we just do extremes here. Everything's just an extreme. Look, guys, I hope you've enjoyed the show. We're going to wrap up now. Thank you, Ignatius, for being with us today. You've been absolutely awesome.
It's a pleasure to be here, guys.
Absolutely fantastic. Selena Green, the Wonder Woman herself. You've been great having you on the show. Hope to have you with us very soon. Yes. I know you're all over the place, traveling the world. All right. And also the one and only I Am Will. You've been great this morning as with us. Yes. You're part of the furniture now.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, breakfast
thank
show you. Crew. And also Kathleen, Lady of Sound. You are absolutely phenomenal. It's been awesome. You did a great job today. Yes, Kathleen. Let's keep it going. All right, but I hope we've learned a lot today, and let's make sure that we are not having baggage and vices and things like that that will just impede what we want, which is to be happy and love life. Every human being wants it. Everybody.
That's right.
Even the boss babe, you know, like he needs to submit to me. Even she wants to be happy.
But
God is the one who created the whole idea, concept, made us how we are. So let's just stick with that, shall we? Yes. Tonight at 8 p.m., we've got Love Talk happening here in the Rainbow Theatre.
I believe that today we even have the Singles
Hour. Singles Hour tonight, guys. If you are single, then make sure you're there. Check it out. I'm telling you, it's going to look like I'm looking. Of course you're looking. You're single.
Right?
You're looking.
Yeah, I'm looking.
That's it. You've got this lovely lady here, Sabrina. Lovely lady, Selena. Second time I did it this morning. I changed my life. I've known you for how many years? I'm telling you, nowadays I'm getting the name wrong. Like, my goodness. Selena, yeah, that's it. So if you are a man out there, you know, that is it. You get gauge it. All right, I hope we'll be there as well. Yeah. I'm saying, because we all want to be at Will's wedding. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I was going to say, this is like back-to-back weeks you guys mentioned my wedding, you know. There's quite a few people inviting themselves to my wedding. You know?
That's it, my friend. We're wishing you well, brother. Love inside of our hearts, yeah. Look, guys, so tonight, 7 p.m. is the Singles Hour. 8 p.m. is the Love Talk, all right? Rainbow Theatre is a beautiful venue. I wish we had like a video showing or images inside. How beautiful the venue is. Wherever you are in the UK, wherever in London, you could jump on. If you are in another country or continent, find out where your local Universal Church or UCKG Help Centre is, and definitely I'll be having it there as well. But that's it. Let's be all happy and love. Elliot says, great show, guys. Thank you. Yes, there it is. Look at that. There's that lovely image.
Brilliant.
That's the Rainbow Theatre. So epic creepy. Building.
Yeah.
That's it. And I don't know if we've got shots inside. Okay, look at that. You know what I'm saying? Wow, that means it.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I come in, I walk through the corridor.
There's an aisle there.
When you're getting married, that's the aisle that you're going to walk down.
That's yes. Wow. That. You visualize powerful. It. Oh, you feel it. J'ai amour. This is a Rainbow Theatre, guys. You're going to absolutely love it. It's going to be those that you can speak to. And it's just going to be absolutely beautiful here at the Love Therapy. All right. Chanel says, mouthful nuggets as always. Bye, Breakfast Show fam over there in South Africa. Yes, guys, look, tomorrow's going to be Replay Friday on the Breakfast Show. Sorry. All right. Let us know in the Breakfast Show WhatsApp line if there's anything you want us to replay. Also, another thing, we're about to reach 2,700 followers on the Instagram. I should have mentioned it before. So look, if you're not on the Instagram yet, make sure you join the Instagram. I think we just need two more to read. There it is. It's on the screen.
We've actually already reached it.
Oh, it's already there.
I was about to say.
Wow. That's good.
We always want more.
That's it. We keep going, because there's 3,000 to get to. We have to get to 3,000, right?
We need to get to 3,000.
Drop it like it's hot. So let's keep it moving. Keep sharing it. Keep sharing the material. Everybody needs to know about this Liberty Radio platform, man, because there's so many good things. You know, things that have been spoken about that's not spoken about everywhere in a certain type of way.
Yeah.
And you can find it all here. Wherever, it doesn't matter what you're going through, whether it's depression, unhappiness, or things are going well, you just want to be able to be more to serve your community. More, or you just want to hear more about Love Life Talk, or being a youth and using your energy for what is good, serving your community, all that good stuff is happening here on the Liberty Radio platform.
Yep, that's right.
You know what I mean? At 12 o'clock, we've got Soul Raising Hour. You know, it's going to be absolutely phenomenal. So don't miss a Breakfast Show beat as well. We have our Breakfast Show WhatsApp line. If you haven't joined the Breakfast Show WhatsApp line, it's on your screen right now. What is it, Kat?
It is +44 75 79 79 6845.
and a yen card.
Plus 44, 75, 79, 79, 6845.
That's the number. Yay! Okay, guys, so just a message, say, look, add me to the Breakfast Show broadcast. You don't miss a Breakfast Show beat. Other than that, I think we're done for today. It's awesome.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, we're good. We're good. Ooh. All right.
Elliot says he wants to visit the help center.
Absolutely.
This summer.
Oh, my bro, it'd be great to have you with us. It'd be great to have you. Cool. And hopefully we'll have some sunshine, eh?
We'll try.
I was going to say, you can't bring any from the Netherlands. I was going to say, the Netherlands weather is very similar to ours.
Yeah, Europe.
Yeah.
Really
Yeah.
Europe. Yeah. But anyway, it'll be great to have Elliot with us. That's a great, that's important thing. That's a great thing. And his wife, meet his family. All right, guys, that's it. We're done for today. Until next time, we'll be live on Monday, same Breakfast Show time, 8 a.m., same Breakfast Show channel, libertarian.co.uk, and just listening tomorrow as we're going to have our revisit. Until then, you're awesome.
Ciao
for now. This camera over here, guys. That's it. Farewell. And you're going to see our picture at the end when we go on Instagram, so make sure you're following.
Yes, follow the Instagram.
Follow Instagram. Voila!
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Really hope you enjoyed this episode of the program. We have a lot more episodes covering a lot more themes on The Breakfast Show. And guess what? Your experience can be even deeper and more interactive because we are live weekdays from Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. on libertyradio.co.uk. On that Liberty Radio platform, we have a whole host of other inspirational material. As well as that, we have our Breakfast Show in the mornings. Check it out. There's a live chat, there's a video feed, and you can get up to date on all the Breakfast Show antics and fun, vim, excitement, and all that kind of crazy stuff that we love to enjoy. This is Robbie here, Robust Presenter, and I hope to see you live and enjoy the next one.